Hello friends, welcome to my channel Amrita's Code World. Today in this video, I am going to specially discuss about the students who are going to appear for Term 1 Class 12 CBSE Board Examination for the subject Computer Science. So I hope students that whatever tips I am going to share, it will help you to score 35 out of 35 in your upcoming board examination, which will be held on 21st of December. So just watch till the end so that you can start follow the instructions which I am going to share with you right now. Before I begin, friends, if you have not yet subscribed to my channel, if you want this kind of videos in future, so please do subscribe my channel, click on the bell icon for the further notification, and also please do like my channel. Let us begin. First of all students, I would like to again mention, you already know about it, the question paper of Computer Science subject code 083 will be divided into three sections, that is A, B and C. Section A, which will consist of 25 questions, you'll have to attempt any 20 questions. In section B, you'll have to attempt any 20 questions out of 24 questions. Section C, which consists of case study based questions, out of 6 questions, you'll have to attempt any 5 questions. So 55 questions will be there, you'll have to attempt any 45 questions out of this section A, B and C. And you already know that all questions carry equal marks. Now, as you know, the duration of examination will be 90 minutes, 1.5 hour, and maximum marks, that is 35, and it is covering the 50% of the entire syllabus. And you already know the chapters, which are the topics you'll have to prepare. First point, the first tip which I'm going to give you, that is focus on theory. Each and every topic of all the chapters you should thoroughly study, because MCQ questions can be based on any topic from your syllabus. So to attempt the objective type of questions, if you study all the chapters thoroughly, that is theory of each chapter, then it will help you to attempt all types of objective questions and you can score well. So don't leave any topic whatever is included in the syllabus. So focus on theory. Second tip which I will share with you, that is practice sample papers. More and more sample papers, there are different types of sample papers are available nowadays, you can easily download it from internet. So more and more sample papers, if you practice, then more and more efficient you will be for attempting the questions. So practicing sample papers, very 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 important. Next is that when you are practicing sample papers, at the same time you clear the concepts. Okay, because you know the topics of your syllabus. So whenever you are practicing any problem, say for example, you are practicing a problem which is based on maybe count function of a string. So what does count function do? Then immediately you can refer that in your theory. Similarly, say for example, you come across one question in the sample paper which is having the code with readline function of file handling. So when you are studying readline function, you can again refer read, readline, readlines. What are the functions which are available in file handling for reading the text file content? At the same time, again, you can again refer the functions which are used for reading operation for CSV file, or binary file problems. So when you are practicing sample papers, that time you refer the concept of that particular topic. So then this way you can save time. So when you are practicing the sample paper on one topic and related topics, if you can cover at the same time, it will of course save the time. Then next, during examination, think positive and be calm. Think positive and be calm. That is very important. No matter whatever question paper you get, you will have to be very cool during examination time. Most of the time, you will score well. If you think positive during examination, you will be able to solve all type of questions. And you know, no question will be given out of syllabus. So any question is given. See, for example, output problems, which most of the students find it difficult. I am telling you, as per my teaching experience, that most of the students, they find it difficult to solve the output problems, or maybe some file handling problems, which is asking you to choose the correct option from the four options given. So output problems also, if you know the concept, if you know how to solve this for loop concept or while loop concept, or if any conditional statement is given, just follow the steps. That time you'll have to think positive and be calm. One draft paper will be given to you. So on that paper, on that page, you just solve it, you write it, each and every steps of the output problems, and then easily you can get the output. So think positive. Next, which is very important, read each question thoroughly. Most of the time, the students, they don't read the question during examination thoroughly. That is very important. Like say, for example, suppose the question is demanding, find the valid identifier from the following options. It may also demand that find the invalid identifier. So read the question, whether it is asking for valid or invalid identifier. Or some questions can be given like, out of the four options, which option is correct? Which statement is correct? About, say for example, about binary file. So you see that whether it is asking for that, which statement is correct or which statement is incorrect. So reading question thoroughly, it's very, very, very important. Then next, the ideal way to solve the MCQ questions is that identify the wrong options. Elimination. What do we mean by that? Four options will be given. Now, some questions you'll find that you can easily find out the correct option. Some of the questions you'll find some confusion might arise that which option is correct. So you start eliminating. Out of the four options A, B, C, D, just take, okay, the option B, yes, no, that B option is totally incorrect, so it is not possible. Then other three options are left, like A, C and D. Then out of this A, C, D, which one you feel that which is not possible at all? So then you just remove that. Then out of this other two, then you come to the conclusion which one is the correct option. So this way, by elimination, you can find out the correct option out of the four options. The next, which is very important, student, that is time management. 90 minutes, that means 1.5 hour will be given to you. But try to complete latest by 1 hour 15 minutes. So that last 15 minutes, you can just go through all the questions and whether you have written the correct option in the Weimar sheet or not. That is very important. So time management is very, very, very important. Regarding time management, I would like to point out this one. Answer easy questions quickly. The questions which you feel that you don't need to think over it, you can easily answer it. So attempt those questions first and write the options. If you are not sure about any question, don't write the correct option that time. Do it at the end when there is no time, not much time left. That time you write the option. If you are not very sure about those options, then difficult questions which involve more steps, attempt at the end. Suppose you are not very comfortable with the output problems or where the coding is given. So those type of questions you attempt at the end, because if you attempt it at the first when you are starting with the examination, then what will happen for solving those type of problems? It will take a lot of time. Then whatever the questions you can easily attempt, you may end up with not solving those questions or not attempting those questions because of lack of time. So difficult questions which involve more steps, you should attempt at the end, because by the time you know that you have already attempted most of the questions and you are that time mentally relaxed that okay, only few questions are left. Out of those questions, you have only few questions which are difficult and you'll have to quickly finish off answering. So difficult questions which involve more steps, you should attempt at the end. Now I would like to highlight few important topics of term 1 which you should practice. See here, first one I have given, valid and invalid identifiers. Keywords, what are the list of keywords available in Python? Different types of operators, arithmetic operator, bitwise operator, logical operator, membership operators, and punctuators, literals. What type of different types of literals are available? Like string literal, numeric literals, boolean literals, special type of literal, none. Then different types of expressions, comments, doc string. What are the symbols that are used for comments? Statement, simple statement, compound statement, block and indentation. Then variables, the concept of variables, which is very important. Multiple assignment of a variable. Different types of error. Some of the questions will be given, which will be asked, like maybe this is what type of error, whether it is a name error or type error or value error or syntax error. Then how to check address of a variable, type of variables, local and global variables, the scope of variables. Then dynamic typing nature of a variable, swapping of variables. Then print function with the separator, sep and end. Data types, different types of data types which are available in Python. String slicing, concept of string slicing, this is very important. Different types of expression. Type conversion, implicit type and explicit type of data type of conversion. Then math module functions, different types of functions of different modules of Python. Simple and compound statement, which I already mentioned. Flow of control, sequence flow of control, selection flow of control, iteration. Control statements, decision making, iteration, jump statement. Then difference between while loop and for loop. While loop and for loop with else. In concept of infinite loop, nested loop. Then jump statements like break, continue and pass. Then different string related functions, list functions, tuple functions, string list and tuple operations. What are the operations can be done? Some of the operators can be used with string, some of the operators can be used with list or tuple, some of the operators which we cannot use with this type of data types. Then dictionary and also all its functions like keys function, values function, which is very important. Then the difference between split and partition functions, bubble sort and insertion sort technique. Then concept of functions, which are very important. Different types of parameters or arguments, required and positional arguments, keyword arguments, default arguments, variable length arguments. Also What do you understand by formal parameter and actual parameters? Then local and global scope, resolution of function, then non-local variable, then the concept of pass-by value, pass-by reference, random module functions like random functions, random functions, uniform function, random range function, choice functions of random module. Then random number problems, different types of problems will be maybe given to you with the random functions. Then output problems, which is very important. You'll have to practice more and more output related problems. They will ask you that find the output of the following program. So that concept is very much important. Then flow of execution of function, like when a code involves multiple functions, from where the program execution starts, from which line to which line. Then concept of return statement, which is used in a function. Strip functions, L-strip, R-strip, for what purpose it is used. Different modes of opening a file in file handling. The concept of absolute path and relative paths of files, which is very important. Then evaluate the expressions, like combine operators will be given, mixed operators will be given to you, arithmetic operator, relational operators, one in an expression. You'll have to evaluate the expressions. For that, you need to know about the operator precedence. You need to know about operator precedence, like when different types of operators are used in a single expression, then how these are executed. Then file handling problems, like you should have the concept of text file, binary file, CSV file. Then different types of modules like math module, random module, waste module, pickle module, which is used for binary file problems, CSV module, sys module. Different modes of opening a file in file handling. Then difference between read, readline and readlines function in a file handling. Then also difference between different read-write operations of text, CSV and binary file problems. There are many more topics, but which are important, mostly these topics you should cover, student. Okay friends, hope this video will help you to prepare for the upcoming board examination for the subject computer science. And if you really like my channel, please do subscribe my channel Amrita's Code World. If you want this kind of videos in future, and don't forget to click on the bell icon to get notified, and also please don't forget to like my channel. Thank you. Thanks for watching.